Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to create a lava material. First, create a material and then click it to open the window. Next, create a texture sample node by clicking while holding down T on the keyboard, and set it to the fire tile texture provided by Start Content. Next, create the panner node and connect it to the texture sample node. And after creating the text cord node, set the text cord and panner values like the video. Connect text cord node to panner node. Now, duplicate the nodes created so far twice. Set the texture sample of one of the copied nodes to Rock Basalt Normal, provided by Start Content. Next, press the keyboard and click to create an add node, and then connect the texture sample nodes to the add node. If you preview the add node, the red channels of fire tiled and rock basalt are merged to show white and black areas. Next, create the power node, set the exponent value of power node to 0.5. Now, when you preview the power node by connecting the add node to the power node, you can see that the black part has disappeared a bit more compared to the add node. Next, create a component masked node and connect it to the texture sample node in Rock Basalt. Next, hold down M on the keyboard and click to create a multiply node and click to create a parameter node while holding down S on the keyboard. Set the value of the parameter node. Now, connect the component masked and parameter nodes to multiply nodes like the video. And connect the multiply node to the normal node. Next, create the multiply node once more and connect the remaining texture sample and power nodes to the multiply node. Then, connect the multiply node we just connected to the emissive color. Next, create two multiply nodes. And connect the two multiply nodes you created. Next, create a time node and a sine node. If you preview the sine node after connecting the time node to the sine node, you can see the material flickering with time. increase the sign period value to about 10 to slow down the bleaking cycle. Then, create a clamp node, set the min of the clamp node to about 0.2, and connect it to the sign node to prevent the sign value from falling below the min value. Next, create a parameter node to set the parameter value. Then, connect the parameter node to the clamp and multiply nodes, and connect the clamp node to the multiply node to control the level of the lava's shininess. Now, save and return to the content browser. In Place Actor, place the plane mesh in an appropriate place in the level and then set the mesh scale larger. Next, right-click the lava material created so far to create an instance and set it to plane mesh. You can now click on the material instance to open a window where you can set the brightness of the lava or the strength of the normal. Thank you.